Okay, I want to talk about a very old problem. It's gone by different names. One of them is the theorem on friends and strangers. So what we're going to do is, Brady, we're going to update this for the kids, make it kind of hip. We're not going to talk about adults at a dinner party. We're going to talk about people on Facebook.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, we're down.
You're down with that?
Yeah.
You're down with 1 billion people on Facebook? We've got 6 people on Facebook, okay? There's more than 6 people on Facebook, you know that. Now, there's certain relationships you can have. You can either be connected, which we're going to say is green. Okay, so this dude's connected to this dude, this person's connected to this person, this person's connected to this person, or you're not. So you're like, this guy doesn't know this person's blocked this person here doesn't know they exist, this person, they don't even speak the same language. Okay, so this is the situation. Now, if we think about, if we're now going to try and count how many different arrangements we can have of 6 anonymous people on Facebook, so there's actually 15 different connections between people, but each connection is either you're friends or you're not friends. To count that, we actually go 2 to the power 15. Okay, so that's what that's how to count how many we've got. So that number is 32768. So you've got 15 lines. Each one can either be a friend or not a friend. Sorry, I don't want to be friends with you. Don't try and stop requesting to be friends. I don't want to be friends with you, okay?
No.
This is you, this is your mum, and it's like, no, mum, go away. Or this is your dad, it's like, uh-uh. You know, yeah. We're connected in the house, not on Facebook.
You drew that quite randomly.
Yep.
There were nearly 33,000 different ways you could have done that.
There's exactly 32,768 different ways you can do that, Brady. Don't round it up. So obviously you could have like, I don't know, it's like you could have like One Direction, right, and their manager. They'd all be green. They're all connected. And then if you've got like members of your family, like we said before, nobody's connected. It's a lot of complexity on Facebook if you think about all those different connections. But just looking at a very small subset of just 6 people, look how many connections we've got. So the question is, what can we say about every single possible permutation, every single possible combination? Is there anything that we can glean? Because we want to try and find order out of chaos as mathematicians. We want to go, what can we learn about any possible one? If you gave me one of these at random, what could I say? Without even looking at it, I could go, I know exactly something about it. So what we can say about any random arrangement of friendships or not friendships, we can say for any single one, any of these 32,768, there's always 3 people that are friends or 3 people that are not friends.
But it could be more.
And it could be more, because like in the One Direction band manager thing, there's lots of groups of 3, right? But the point is that it's an at least. So at least means, okay, this is the absolute minimum. So either 3 people are friends or 3 people are not friends. And that's the order that we can do. So why? Is there a reason behind that? Can we prove it? We can, okay? So this is how we're going to prove it. First of all, we're going to try and simplify things, okay? So now let's just look at one. This is too complicated. Let's just look at one guy, okay? One person. So one person could be friends here. We're just looking at the connections. I don't want to color them up just yet. So it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you think, okay, so what can we know about these friendships that this person has with all these people? We've got 5 lines and we want to know what color are they? They're going to be green or they're going to be dotted red? They're going to be friends or not friends? So if we look at 5, we could actually see, all right, we could just start kind of counting in a funny way. So we can kind of go, oh yeah, there's a situation where there could be 5 all friends, and then this guy's not friends with nobody, okay?
He's popular, dude.
He's popular, yeah. He's friends with everybody, okay? He's a bit of an Obama. He's a politician. That's when, this is the politician here. He's friends with everybody. The other one could be instead, it could be he's friends with 4 people, and he's not friends with 1 person. So you can keep going like this. And now actually we can just fill this out here. So we get 3, 2, 1, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the different ways we can do it. Now, if we look at every single possibility there, So here we know one of the at least things. So here we know, look, if it's five friends and zero not friends, well, we know that that is, well, that's definitely greater than three friends there. Four, well, that's greater than three friends there. Three, that's greater than three friends there. Two, well, that's not greater than three friends there, but now it's greater than three not friends. And this is greater than three not friends, and this is greater than three not friends. So you know that any way you break this up, or any combination of like friends or not friends, there's always, one person is always friends with at least three people, or not friends with at least three people. And that's the kind of tricky bit. If you can get your head around that, the next bit should be cool. So let's just draw up another random anonymous, just to kind of keep it clean. Here's our guy here. So let's actually say he is friends with at least three people, or it could be the opposite, right? But we're going to go, he's friends with this person, he's friends with this person, and he's friends with this person. Now what we want to do is, we're going to try and force the worst situation, okay? So what we're trying to do is we're trying to show that the theorem says at least three people know each other, or at least three people don't know each other. So let's try and push it to the extreme. So in that sense, it's like we want to try and make sure that we don't want three people to know each other to be friends on Facebook. So that means we're going to go, okay, so if this guy, and this guy were all friends, they would all be green. We don't want that. We want these ones to be red. So we put a dashed red line there. These guys aren't friends. But there's another triangle here. So it's green, green. No, no, we don't want you to be friends. Because we're trying to force.
You're trying to avoid a threesome at all costs.
We are trying to avoid a threesome at all costs. That's exactly right, Brady. So here, we don't want these guys to be friends. But look, there's another triangle there. So now we don't want these guys to be friends. But look what's happened. By trying to avoid this guy making, we've created, inadvertently, we've actually created three people that don't know each other. We've created like a threesome of anonymity.
Which was our Andor.
And you can see now, if we flipped it, if now this guy wasn't friends, nor wasn't friends, and we made these guys friends, it would be the opposite situation. So this is order out of chaos. For every single possible 32,768, every possible combination of being friends or not friends, it's always the case that you always find a clique of three people that are friends with one another, or three people can't stand each other, or don't know each other, or are your mum and your dad.